we're expecting $2 trillion of investment in AI infrastructure by 2030. Half a trillion of that is in the data center segment.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me in the studio today is Brian Burns. He's partner at PwC for Telecoms and Technology Strategy. Brian, thank you very much for coming through.
Thank you.
So Brian, what do you see as the main drivers of development in the digital infrastructure segment?
Look, I think I'd highlight two areas. One is AI, and the second is data sovereignty. So let's talk about AI. We're expecting $2 trillion of investment in AI infrastructure by 2030. Half a trillion of that is in the data center segment. And that the quantum of that investment is driving the opportunity both for the digital infrastructure segment, so the data centers, the connectivity, et cetera, which goes alongside that, but also the broader ecosystem, the broader industrial ecosystem. So we're seeing it impacting energy grids, demand for semicon, of course, and also reuse of industrial facilities to support this growth. I think maybe the second area is data sovereignty. So I think over the past 1 to 2 years, I think having data sovereignty localized within country is becoming increasingly important for customers. We're seeing demand for neo clouds and AI infrastructure within country rather than seeing data flowing across borders in a way that it may have done so in the past. And we think that's going to be an opportunity within the segment.
Is this all about hyperscale data centers or are other subsectors attractive, Brian? What are the hottest areas of opportunity in the European market?
I think that the hyperscale data center segment rightly commands attention given a lot of the investment going in there. But it's by no means the only area where we see opportunity in the digital infrastructure segment. So if we look at edge data centers, both for business co-location of their servers, as well as low latency or AI inferencing applications. We look at the utility-like and growth that we see in the towers segment, as well as then connectivity, both in terms of the wholesale or long distance fibre connectivity, as well as some of the fibre to the premise segments we see opportunity.
What does the regulatory landscape for digital infrastructure look like?
I think if we look back decades previously, a lot of the focus of regulatory intervention and the metrics of success of regulatory intervention were around price as the consumer outcome. I think over time, we've seen more of a rebalancing of price versus quality, where regulators are keen for infrastructure to be rolled out to give the best quality networks for their citizens. And I think if we look at the broader public policy angle, we only have to look in the last few weeks here in the UK. We had the UK 10-year infrastructure strategy, which has been developed. And digital infrastructure was a core part of that and possibly not something we would have seen 10, 20 years ago. So I think overall we see relatively benign both regulatory regime, but also supportive broader public policy angle.
How can a company like Cordiant create value in digital infrastructure?
I think it comes, first of all, you've got to acquire the right companies at the right price. But then when you've done that, you've got to think through what is your value creation story so that I'm going to end up with a better business than the one I bought. And then also, what is my talent strategy to put high quality management teams, the right talent around that to execute on the strategy?
Brian, thank you very much for coming in and sharing your insights.
Thank you.
That's Brian Burns, partner at PwC for Telecoms and Technology Strategy.